My name is Natasha and I'm from India. I've been working here for, well, I've been in New Zealand for 2.5 years, and I've been studying animation, and I have, I've been working as a 3D artist, and I really like New Zealand because of, you know, Lord of the Rings and the work they've done at Weta. And yeah, I love traveling and I really like this country. My journey with AJV started with me in India, and Shanti sent me a mail telling me about India Design School, and they were looking to get new students in that year. So I did apply, and she, when I got in, she helped me out with my visas, and she asked me to get all the documents that I needed. So I didn't really have to deal with the immigration officers much when I came out of India, and the journey was pretty smooth. So once I got here, the school took care of some of the stuff for me, and my school year was great. But after that, I was left to my own devices, and I had to get my own visas and then look for work, stay in the country, and it was kind of tough. So I had some freelance work and some contract work, but that wasn't good enough to get a work visa or a residency to stay any longer. So I was looking for help from lawyers, and you know, most people out here, they'd give you a free session and they'd talk to you about whether or not you could get a residency or a work visa, and most of them would just tell me that you probably won't get anything because you don't have a full-time job, even though most work that comes for artists these days is in through a contract for, you know, or a freelance kind of contract. So I was really tense and I was looking for something very desperately. And Nishanti from AJV, she said that she had a colleague in New Zealand called Arun, and he would help us out if someone wanted help, and he knew about immigration advice and works and stuff like that. So I contacted him and I told him that I was working full-time with a Canadian company, and I was getting freelance work from a lot of companies in New Zealand. So he thought maybe we could apply from the Canadian company, because even though they're based in Canada, they had a company here, New Zealand one. So we could probably get to using that. And I also had a freelance contract, like a position at another animation company at the same time here. And we applied for a residency and a work visa. We spent like a couple of months getting all the documents together, and we were pretty confident that something would come through pretty soon. But then by the time we filed all of our documents and stuff, my visa was coming to an end, and I needed a new visa to stay in the country. And I asked them, could I work for two companies and, you know, give me permission to do this. So they probably skipped over the whole thing, and they just gave me a visa to work for one company, and I was pretty tense because I couldn't stop working for the other company, and I didn't want to work illegally and piss the immigration people off. So Arun was like, don't worry about it, we'll handle it. And he really handled it really well. He contacted the offices. He was like, she needs to work, and you know, you need to give the visa as soon as possible. And they gave it to me the next day, and I could work for two companies legally and while I was waiting for my residency. So that was great. And then we thought the residency would be great as well, because it's pretty straightforward. Here's a company, I'm working for it, and I have a 1-year contract. But it wasn't, and it took 8 months for the whole process to go through, and there were some complications because my contract ended with the other company, and the company I'm working for right now, since it was not completely New Zealand, they needed the right documents and they were not willing to look at it as work. So even though I was pretty skilled and I'm getting work and I have a lot of potential, they were not really looking at me, and they were like, you probably had to go back home. So I was pretty scared, and Arun was like, don't worry about it, we really work hard, we'll try and convince these guys and we'll do the right thing. And I was really happy. I mean, it was like a emotional process that was really scary, but it worked out and they were convinced and everything was fine, and I got my residency a couple of months ago. And you know, I think thanks to Arun, because he wasn't just helping me out as a immigration officer, he was also helping out as a friend, and he would really tell me to relax and not be so worried about all these things, and I was pretty happy. And yeah, so I got my residency, I got work, and I'm pretty happy here.